Hi everybody, Melanie here. It's a lovely day today, so I'm outside today. I'm going to make a gift basket in this lovely rattan container that I picked up at my garden centre. Can you see that? It's round with a ball inside. Let's have a look at the plants that we're going to be putting in. I did write the names down. This one here, can you see that one? There we are. This one is called Acordium. Acordium recitum, croton houseplant. So we're going to put that at the back to give it some height. And then we have the lovely asparagus fern, which we use a lot in weddings. There's different types of asparagus fern. This one here, which is really interesting. Can you see this one? This one here with a twist held like that, it's called a snake plant from Africa, and I thought it was lovely. It's like, feels like a succulent because it's quite thick stalks, and hopefully it will grow like that. Then we have a bit of colour. This one here is a calancho, and then we have an ivy, which is variegated. Variegated means it normally has in the variegated, it's two different colours in the leaf. Then we've got this, I love this, little baby succulent there. You see that one? And this one, everybody, is just gorgeous. I love this. It's called Baby Tears in English. And its name, let me have a look. Nettera grandisis, English baby tears with orange berries. Isn't it just beautiful? Right, here we are. We've got our bowl ready here. I will write all the plants down in the description. If you want to have a go at making this yourself, let me know if you do. It'd be fantastic. Right, let's get some soil. Today, I'm just going to use a typical grow bag. And that's quite good for plants. I normally always use that in my hanging baskets. It's quite moist, so we'll just do this. We don't need any gravel in the bottom. We don't need any holes because they are succulents, mostly. So you can make this quite dry. So we need it quite a bit in. You need to put a bit halfway with your soil. Same in hanging baskets as well. I'll do that next spring. Do the hanging baskets. So, if you need any fluttering or buzzing, it's lots of bees today. Some more soil in. I would normally pick the bag up, but I'm not that strong. See, there's a ridge there actually, if you can see it in the bowl. So if you go to there and then you can sort all the rest out. I think this is going to look lovely. And to look after it, really, because there's a lot of succulents, they like dry soil and some like moist. So what I will do is the ones that like moist soil, I will put to one side. And the ones that don't, the only watering I'll probably give them is by spray bottle. So just put some water in the spray bottle. Sorry it's taking me so long to fill it. Didn't realise how deep it was. Let's have a go. To find that if you use me, I'm terrible for not wearing gardening gloves because they're just, if you're trying to do things, they're a bit clumsy and too thick on the ends of the fingers for my hands. Right, so we've got it roughly to there. If you can see that, let me lift it up so you can see it all. Okay, so you can see where the line is in the bowl, and you just fill your soil up to there. I'm going to start with the back one first to give it the height. So we'll start with the tall one. Just squeeze it out like that. Any of the soil, just mix it in near where you're going to put it. And actually, I might leave that label, take that label off. We're going to put a little bit of soil up the back there, and then use your hand to put that in there. We want to get it quite far back and in the middle, like so. And then just press around the soil. Right, now I'm going to put my asparagus fern in. I'm going to put it on the right. So I take it out from the pot, squeeze it gently. As you can see, that needed to come out of there. Right, when it's like that compacted, the roots, what you need to do is just gently squeeze it. Just gently squeeze it, because that way then it'll adapt to its new environment. So I'm going to move a bit of soil again and put that there. Make sure it goes down enough and spread it about a bit so it shows where you want it to go. So we've got the two plants in now. Right, let me go for the, let's have a look. The succulents need to be near the front. Calancho there. I'll put the calancho in next. The season's colours seem to be hot pink, don't they, and orange, so I thought these would be good. So gently, again, squeeze the roots, like so. Then dig a portion for where you want it to be. Don't be frightened of moving the plants in next to each other. And pat it down around near the centre of them. So that's looking nice so far. Right, which way are we going to put that? Yeah, I'm going to put the snake plant in next. I'll put it on the left side. I think this is a really interesting plant. I've not had one of these before. So again, the snake plant, we're going to put that in here. Its own little spot, so to say. You can manipulate them quite a bit, and hopefully this is going to grow that tall. Right, now we're going to put our, let's have a look, might put it to the side. Might, you can arrange them, you know, so that you, what you want to go where and things. Yeah, to be honest, I think I might put that there if there's room. Put that there. Move the calancho a little bit. And we've got our ivy. Just squeeze the, there's the roots on it. Just squeeze them gently like this. It's very dry. But they do like it quite dry, ivies. I'm going to put that in there. And I will top it up with some more soil once I've got them in place and that they can spread the roots. Because you don't want too much. So that's it so far. We're getting there. It's looking really nice. Right, let's, yeah, that's what I'll do. I'll put the baby tears in. It is just gorgeous, this little plant. So that's the bottom of it, and I'm going to put that down here and get some more soil, put it near the snake plant. I'll give that that one, and then we'll put that there. I need a bit more soil to lift it up a bit, because it's shorter than the other plants. So lift it up just that little bit. There we are. Show it off itself. So I'll make sure that that's near the edge. I need a bit more soil in the centre there. So I'll just put it over the top so I don't get it all over it. Making sure that each plant has got enough soil. Lift it up like that. And you don't want it too above the actual plant soil level that it was at before. But this one, the soil was quite near the top. I will trim this ivy in a second. Right. We've got a tiny little succulent now. I'm going to put that in. Isn't it gorgeous? It's like you could put that in a little doll's house. It's just so cute. and it's quite small. So we're going to push that like that, and that needs a bit more soil. I'm going to try and find a terrarium, I think, as well, because I love doing them. Because it's got its own, you don't have to worry about them too much. If you spray inside the terrarium, it's got its own ecosystem. With a little brush to brush that. So these will all find their own space. Let's just put them there. Let me try and trim that. I've got some secateurs somewhere. Right, will be a moment. There we are. Let's see. Now this one's a little bit skimpy there, so we'll just take that off. And also this one. It's alright, it's not going to harm the plants. Let me have a look now. Let's have a look at the ivy one. Right, so you only, if you're doing this in a shop and it's going to a client, you only want it touching the table really. So you can snip it off about there. Let that one like that. Snip them. When you snip in plants, do it between them. Between the buds and between the leaves. A bit blunt, these. Get them there now. Yeah, I'm quite pleased with that. I could put a ribbon in there, but I'm not going to do, because sometimes ribbon with the wires, they can rust, and you don't want the rust leaking into the soil. So put that, just jiggle them about to where you want them to go. Like so. There we are. A lovely planted basket. Hope you can see that. Oops, sorry about that. So that's the little planted basket. There we go. Just thought I'd do something different today. It's lovely weather. All right then. I'll speak to you later. Take care, everybody. Bye.